Have you ever wondered why your electronic devices sometimes don't work as efficiently as they should? Hey guys, in this video, I will explain what is a voltage drop and how to calculate the voltage drop across a resistor and an LED. Stick around until the end, because I'll show you a practical way to measure voltage drop using a multimeter. To grasp the concept of voltage drop, it's essential to first understand electric potential. Electric potential, often referred to simply as voltage, is the measure of potential energy per unit charge in an electric field. Think of it as the push that drives electric charges through a circuit. This push is what powers all the components in your circuit, from resistors to LEDs. Imagine you have a 9-volt battery. This battery creates an electric potential difference between its two terminals. The positive terminal has a higher electric potential than the negative terminal. When a circuit is connected to the battery, this potential difference causes electric charges, or electrons, to flow from the negative terminal to the positive terminal, creating an electric current. As the electric current flows through the circuit, it encounters various components like resistors and LEDs. Each component has its own resistance, which opposes the flow of current. When current passes through a resistor, some of the electric potential energy is converted into heat energy due to the resistance. This conversion results in a decrease in the electric potential or a voltage drop across the resistor. To put it simply, voltage drop is the reduction in electric potential as the current flows through the resistance of a component. It's like the energy used up by that component to perform its function, whether that's lighting an LED or generating heat in a resistor. Ohm's law is fundamental in understanding voltage drop. It states that the voltage, V, across a resistor is equal to the current, I, flowing through it multiplied by its resistance, R. V equals to I times R. This relationship shows how voltage, current, and resistance are interconnected. If you know any two of these values, you can calculate the third. Let's examine voltage drop using a circuit that includes a 9-volt battery, a resistor, and an LED. Connect the red jumper wire to the positive terminal of the breadboard. Connect the black jumper wire to the negative terminal of the breadboard. Connect the red alligator clip to the red jumper wire. Connect the black alligator clip to the black jumper wire. For the resistance, I'm using a 470 ohm resistor. Bend the wire ends of the resistor and insert them into the breadboard. The left resistor wire should be in the same column as the positive terminal of the breadboard. For the LED, I'm using a red LED with a forward voltage of around 2 volts. Make sure the longer leg or positive terminal is on the left. Connect the red alligator clip to the positive terminal of the battery. Connect the black alligator clip to the negative terminal of the battery. The LED lights up, so we have correctly connected the circuit. When the current flows from the battery through the resistor, the voltage drops by 7 volts. This drop signifies that the resistor has used up 7 volts of electric potential to resist the current flow. The remaining 2 volts continue to flow through the circuit. As the current passes through the LED, it experiences another voltage drop of 2 volts. This drop happens because the LED, like the resistor, has internal resistance. The electric potential decreases further as the LED converts some of it into light energy. Let's verify the voltage by using a multimeter. Turn the dial to the voltage setting. Touch the red probe to the left side and the black probe to the right side of the resistor. As we can see, the reading indicates approximately 7 volts. Let's check the voltage of the LED. The measurement shows around 2 volts. Let's check the voltage of the battery. As we expected, the reading shows around 9 volts. By the time the current has passed through both the resistor and the LED, the total voltage drop adds up to the initial voltage supplied by the battery, which is 9 volts. Understanding voltage drop is crucial for designing and troubleshooting circuits. If a component in the circuit isn't working correctly, measuring the voltage drop across various components can help identify where the problem lies. For example, if you notice an unexpected voltage drop in a wire, it could indicate issues like corrosion or a loose connection, which adds unwanted resistance to the circuit. I hope this video has explained what is a voltage drop. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.